Coach Mike Federico joining us up here in the booth. I know you've got a father commitment here in just a little bit, so I won't keep you long. But, boy, an offensive explosion today. Kind of were held in check a little bit. Yesterday only 3 runs, 8 hits, but made up for it today. 26 runs on 25 hits, 10 stolen bases, matching the school record. I know you're proud of your team and the way they bounced back from a little adversity, dropping the first game of the series.
Yeah, we got it back even in the series, 1-1, and have a chance tomorrow to come out and take the series, which ultimately that's what we have to learn how to do when we get into our tough conference schedule, which is, you know, at hand, and this is a really good club. They're not going to back down, even though they got beat pretty good today. So I was proud of our guys. It was kind of a weird game at the beginning with kind of both starters getting knocked out a little bit.
Both went 1 1/3. That's just rare you see that.
You could kind of feel that, like it was going to be a little bit of an offensive day. Of course, it's the first time the wind's really been blowing out.
It's the best day we've had.
Oh, it's been beautiful. Today. It's been beautiful, and you know, a lot of crazy stuff happened. I got to give the doctor who showed up in the stands. I don't know if you talked about it, but
I did.
Our staff and everybody did a great job of getting over there and helping that little girl out. And what a scary moment! But whoever that man was, I don't know which doctor it was, but that was awesome, and it was good to get the win. But that was definitely a scary moment.
Yeah, Mike. I saw it happening before y'all did, and people might not know, a little girl was choking here in the stands, and I had to send it to a break. It had me
shook.
I thought
there was a fight. I didn't know what was going on. I heard this lady, and I thought maybe her boyfriend or husband was fighting somebody, and next thing you know, I walk out.
It was
a little girl.
Staring,
she didn't look good, and again, whoever that doctor was, God bless him, and thank him for being here, and I know Mr. McDonald and Lakin were over there, and we had some support from our staff, our trainer and their trainer went up there. It was incredible, and thank God that little girl's okay.
No doubt, and like I said, it as Jeremy Sisk was up here in the booth, it took me about an inning to get back composed, because my kids were here too, so I was worried about one of them too, but nonetheless, absolutely a blessing from God there. Let's get into this game, and kind of, it was tough for teams to recompose after that too. I mean, after that happened, because that's a tough situation, but whenever you guys really settled in offensively, you didn't look bad. The biggest inning, the 11th spot in the 6th, I kind of joked. I said, I wonder if y'all are trying to outdo yourselves from Wednesday night there.
Yeah,
it seemed like for a moment that all was going to be the case.
Yeah, if we can get as many runs as we can, especially getting extra bullpen arms in the game, because hopefully that helps you win on Sunday. So, the goal is not just to score one every inning, it's to score as many as you can. And, when you looked up on the scoreboard, it only showed one at the end of it, because it was 11 runs, because our scoreboard doesn't show the multiple numbers up there. But definitely was a fun inning for our guys. But there was big hits, but there was also, pressure from walks and things like that. Mm-hmm. And if we can get our offense going like that, then the big hits end up coming. And you definitely had some of those with, no offense to Humanek. I know he had a great game, but it was just a solo home run.
Yep.
It
had 5 singles.
But it was all the other stuff that was involved in it. And then that's what, the pitcher ends up going, man, I just need a break. Oh, there's nobody on. And wham, just, you give up a solo shot. And that was huge. And, again, just pressure by our offense with walks. And, they made a couple errors, 3 errors that cost them a little bit too. So I got to commend our offense. And they were very focused. And like I said, the beginning of the game, I kept telling our guys, like, it's going to be one of those offensive days. You could just tell.
I want to give credit to Bryson Roble as well. He had 2 innings but then got hurt.
Yeah.
And he kind of settled things down out there on the mound for you guys also.
He did. He got the first 0, up there, and it was like, okay, finally. We can hang a 0 right here, and then we end up scoring the 4 spot right after it. So that was huge, and we got the lead, and then he unfortunately got hit. And then Justin Barton just came in, and, man, he was just outstanding for us. He's never had to do that before. That's kind of uncomfortable. Coach, everybody's watching me get loose. I'm like, take your time.
I mean, it's what you got. You got to take advantage.
That's right. And he did a great job. I thought Worm did a really good job of catching today with him. And, we turned a couple double plays and some stuff. And I thought our outfielders played exceptionally well, catching a couple of those balls in the gaps.
I want to finish up with just – kind of going to the end of the ball game, and that, you know, it's a nine-inning ball game, and you're constantly coaching. You went out whenever Webb was kind of struggling to find the strike zone, and I imagine what you said to him, but it was a little more of a lengthy conversation. I don't want to get into all the details, mm-hmm. but just, you know, guy who struggled earlier this year in an appearance, seemed to be struggling, settled him down. It's part of coaching, and yeah. then got this game finished out for you.
Yeah, you know, he's a really good arm for us, and I'm expecting big things from him, and every junior college kid that comes in here, it's difficult. This is it's a tough game, and it's not as easy as what it was sometimes in junior college, and they have to make adjustments. You know, Lucas unfortunately didn't have a great fall for us because he didn't practice. He was a little banged up, so we haven't been able to really tinker with him a little bit, and so he's kind of having to learn on the fly. And I tell our guys all the time, hitters and pitchers, that sometimes when games are like this, it's non-competitive moments a little bit, because, and I told him, I was like, look, man, I know the score's out of hand, but this is a competitive moment for you to get yourself back in the mix. I said, we recruited you because we thought you were good, and I still think you are. But if you can't make the adjustments, then look, man, it's on you. And he settled in, and you know, I told him after the game, I said, would you want me to just go out there, and do you want me to see my face out there? And he goes, yeah, coach, I just needed to see you. So he gave me a little smart aleck answer, but it was good that he you know, hung the zero, and gives him a little bit of confidence as well.
Texted you Thursday, saved me some runs. You did, 26. Now leave some for everybody else, okay?
No, we'll do as many runs as we can anytime. Takes a little pressure off of me and the pitching side of it, but yeah, it was definitely good to have you up in the booth.
Glad to
and
be back today.
Always a pleasure to have you with us, and you know, Mark fielding great as well. But thank you for everything, and I'll get you to the more.
Looking forward to talking
people.
To
gotta,
these guys. Go enjoy that dance with your daughter.
Daddy daughter dance.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Go have fun, Coach Mike Federico.